Well, today is Election Day. There will be another reason to celebrate very soon, Greek Independence Day, March 25th. And to give us a preview of how they honor the day, Chef Juan Esquivel and Chris Entzempatzakis is joining us from Mali Cafe. Did I get it right? We were all laying bets on whether or not I was going to be able to pronounce your name. Nice to have you guys back in. Happy Greek Independence Day. Tell us what's going to be involved with this.
Like you said, it's Greek Independence Day this weekend, so we're always going all Greek for brunch this weekend.
Okay, so when you think of Greek, you know, one of the first things that comes to mind for me is, in fact, baklava, right?
Baklava.
Which is one of the things you're going to be making.
Yes.
But you have brought a few other things, so before we get to that, chef, because you're going to make us some pancakes, these are just some of the other things people can get. Not all necessarily Greek food, but delicious, right?
It's all Greek ingredients, yeah.
Greek
is fine.
Okay, so what do we have left?
So this is a Greek yogurt, very perfect.
That's so beautiful.
It looks
look at that. So it's yogurt with honey
Greek
yogurt, which is the best yogurt in the world, am I right?
You are absolutely right.
Okay.
Yes.
And then, so you've taken the traditional dishes that you usually have and added a little Greek touch to each.
Yes, this is a sakanaki omelet, basically, with sauteed peanuts, cage-free eggs, and sakanaki yellow Greek cheese on top.
Okay, and what did you do to make the burger Greek?
This is a Greek berry in the middle.
Oh, okay.
With the feta cheese.
Yes,
and
nice.
And the brioche bun on top.
Oh, I think that's good.
Yes.
I didn't think of feta with the fur burger. That sounds interesting.
You hear
yeah,
it, right?
Very nice. And then what we have here?
This is a chef special, actually. Chef inspired and everything. It's a Greek meatballs. With poached eggs, tzatziki sauce on top, sauteed spinach and tomato.
Wow, poached eggs, tzatziki top, and then tomatoes and spinach. Love it. Okay, and then of course a traditional Greek salad.
Traditional Greek salad.
But now the center stage. What do you make it for, chef?
We want to start making our buttered milk pancakes with a little touch of baklava.
Okay. Wow, that's so. You've infused the baklava in the batter.
Exactly.
How did you do that?
Let's see. We got our signature pancake buttered milk from Mali Cafe. We're going to put it right here, right away.
Which looks really good. I don't know if you guys can get a shot of that pancake over there. This is hilarious. So the pancake batter has some of the baklava infused, but look at what you're doing with that.
Yes, now we're going to start with putting a little bit of nuts, cinnamon, brown sugar, and walnuts.
Wow. That's so... Okay, so now you're letting that cook. But over here is the finished product. Take a shot of this and tell everybody... What exactly is on top of those pancakes?
It's a brown sugar, walnuts, pecans, and almonds.
Wow.
And after that, we put our baklava syrup right in the top.
Baklava syrup?
Which is delicious, you know, what with it.
Okay, wow. I tell you what, that looks so beautiful and nice and sweet. I bet you don't even need the maple syrup, am I right?
Yeah, you can eat it like that.
It's almost there.
A nice touch.
Yeah.
Okay, so tell everybody what they can expect at Mali Cafe. You guys have how many locations?
We have three locations right now. It's the original one in Greektown, and then it's the River North location on Wilson Grant. And now we have the newest one, which is already 4 years old, which is in Printer's Row, Congress and Dearborn.
Very nice. Okay. So where can people go for more information? What's your website?
Website is www.malicafe.com.
Easy enough to remember.
Very easy enough to remember. Don't forget to get your mimosa.
Oh, yes.
Ouzo with fresh squeezed orange juice.
Ouzo with fresh squeezed orange juice, and then looks like a little
a Greek beer.
Greek beer. Yay. What do we say? What Greek word do you want to say for all of this?
You can say opa.
Opa. You always say opa for everything, right? Something spills, you say opa. Something doesn't, you say opa.
It cures everything.
It cures everything. The opa cure all. Thanks so much for coming in.
Can't wait to dig in.
Very, very nice, and happy Greek Independence Day. And coming up, if you've ever wanted to